Welcome, students, to this first screencast of our electrochemical engineering course. In this first screencast, we will discuss electrochemical thermodynamics. Thermodynamics are at the heart of chemical engineering and also at the heart of electrochemical engineering. On this particular module, we will have three screencasts. And this is the first one. In this first one, I will also give the learning goals for the complete module. And these learning goals are listed on this slide. You can see here that the learning goals are that you should be able to use thermodynamic data to calculate equilibrium and thermoneutral cell potentials. You should be able to calculate the standard potential of a half reaction. Use the Nernst equation to calculate electric potentials and know how to construct and interpret a Bourbet diagram. So now let's start with the first part, which is on the equilibrium cell potential. Now here is the first slide on the equilibrium cell potential. And the first thing I want you to know is that the equilibrium cell potential is a component of the total cell potential. And the figure on the left, I will show quite often, also during other modules, because it shows what the total cell potential consists of. And why do I think that figure is so important? Because the cell potential is really a very important key performance indicator in any electrochemical process. Because in an electrolysis process, it indicates how much energy you need to run a process. Whereas, for example, for a battery, it indicates how much energy you can get from an electrochemical process. So it's really a very important point. We will discuss it extensively in module 4, but we already start with it here. Because, as you can see in the equation on the right, the cell potential consists of the thermodynamic contributors, the overpotentials, which we will discuss in module 3, and the ohmic contributors, which we will discuss in module 4. Now, as said, the focus of this first screencast is on the equilibrium cell potentials. And you can see here that there are two values, one for the cathode, one for the anode. Together, they are the equilibrium cell potential. And what is important to know that if you have an electrolysis process, we always say that the cell potential, equilibrium cell potential, is negative, whereas if you have the reverse of an electrolysis process, what we call a galvanolysis process, you have a positive cell potential. Now, how does the equilibrium cell potential relate to thermodynamic data? I assume you all have had courses on thermodynamics, and hence you should be familiar with concepts such as Gibbs energy, enthalpy, and entropy. You should also be familiar with the sources where you can find relevant data, such as the Handbook of Chemistry and Physics, of which I have included a link here. Based on the data, you take a particular reaction, you can calculate what the Gibbs free energy is of such a reaction. Now, this Gibbs free energy is directly related to the equilibrium cell potential via the equation depicted here. So you know the change in Gibbs free energy, and then you can divide it by the number of electrons that take place in a reaction, divided by the Faraday constant, and then you get the equilibrium cell potential. Now, if you want to practice a bit with this, I recommend you to carry out quiz question 2.1. A parameter that is related closely to the equilibrium cell potential is the thermoneutral cell potential, ETN cell. The difference with the equilibrium cell potential is that the thermoneutral cell potential is connected to the change in enthalpy of a certain reaction. Now, why is this such an important value? Because the term neutral cell potential indicates the temperature at which the electrochemical process does not consume any heat or release any heat. So if you operate it at a term neutral cell potential, it will stay at the same temperature. If you operate it above the term neutral cell potential, you are generating heat. And if you operate it below the term neutral cell potential, you are consuming heat. So your cell will cool down. So that's why it is often used in energy efficiency calculations. And the term neutral cell potential is also directly connected to the higher heating value of a reaction. Now here, to practice with the term neutral cell potential, you can carry out quiz question 2.2. One issue that we are facing when using this thermodynamic data is that they are giving at standard conditions, which means 25 degrees Celsius and 1 bar. And sometimes we are looking for data at other temperatures. For example, if we want to run our process at 60 degrees Celsius, we want to know the equilibrium cell potential at 60 degrees Celsius. So how do we then do that? Well, we can then use this equation, which lists that the change in Gibbs energy is equal to the change in enthalpy minus the temperature multiplied by the change in entropy. And basically, then you can say that the change in Gibbs energy with temperature is equal to the change in entropy. And this results then in this equation for the equilibrium cell potential. Here we should note that this is only valid in a relatively small temperature domain, because for larger temperature domains, you typically also see that the enthalpy, the delta H listed here, also starts to show temperature dependence, and then you can no longer use this simplification. So this is a relatively simple method to make a reasonable estimation of equilibrium cell potential at another temperature. So this concludes the first screencast, and you can continue with the second screencast on electrochemical thermodynamics if you like.